Hello and welcome to the channel. A little while back I posted my first ever poll on the community tab. If you haven't found the community tab, search for it at the channel homepage. You will get to the community on your own. And I asked if I should mount or repot my Maxillaria variabilis, which I got from Indische Schaap. My variabilis is in full moss at the moment, and there is a lot of algae. And I thought it time for a repot. So let's get it out of the pot. And let's see what's inside. Yeah, this is algae and not zombie moss. Oof, smelling quite musty. I got it from Insa, and I think there are two parts to it. Let's see. It was quite deep in the pot. Oi, it smells very, very bad. Yes, the moss is well and truly gone over. These are the two little parts. Might have been a bit too late. There are new roots growing here. And some good roots, but there are some old and gone roots too. I'm gonna change the mix from full sphagnum, full moss, to 50-50 or a 70-30 mix with some bark. Well, my belly rumbles. It's hungry. This has a bit more roots. But again, I waited too long. Some of the roots just didn't make it. Let's clean these roots up. If the velamen comes apart, orchid roots are two-part roots. There's a velamen, the outer side, and there's a teeny tiny string inside that is the actual root, and the velamen is the protection and the sponge that gets the roots, the water on, that gets the roots hydrated. And the old roots are all gone. I think I should have potted it earlier. Repotted it. Just 2-3 new roots left. There's a pot very low in the pot. It is climbers. It's a climber, that's why I asked if I should mount it, because most times mounted orchids to climbing orchids do better on a mount than in a pot, but we can adjust the potting and just put the media on the slope to not bury it all. If big parts of the orchid stays inside a moist pot, chances are it will start rotting, or it gives a chance to bacterial infections to take hold and mangle your root system. We're gonna chop up the moss to be quite small, so it mixes right between the orchiata bark . Smaller parts of sphagnum rot easier than bigger parts. If I want it, first of all, a bit of corking down. Some strings, a little bit of corking to accommodate the water being able to get out. Let's see how we will be placing it. Something like that. Gonna put the stake in between the both parts. I hope this is enough, but it probably is. I'm choosing, that's a new shoot, this one, that's a new shoot. I'm not grabbing that one, but I grab the one behind. And that makes there's some room there to make for a repotted Maxillaria variabilis. I'm still happy you gave it to me, Inse. I always thought that Maxillaria variabilis or other Maxillarias are a bit of, yeah, too grassy leaves. But once it came in and once I saw it, I thought, damn, these are quite nice. And as it is growing for me, sort of quite well, I think. Let's hope. It will for sure bloom one day. Let's put a little bit more moss there around the roots. What these normally do is they grow up, and in the old sheets, these are one of the few orchids you should leave the sheets, the old dried up sheets on, but they will shoot the roots through their old sheets down into the media where it will emerge. But sometimes apparently it does that, so I put a little bit more moss here to keep it better hydrated until it moves into the media. And this is, I think this is a nicely repotted Maxillaria variabilis. Hope you enjoyed it. And I'll see you soon on the next one. Houdoe.